Hello friends, I am Mr. G.V. Pujari, working as Assistant Professor, Insurance Top Technology College of Engineering, Edrao. I am teaching subject Machine Drawing. Today, we are going to see in Machine Drawing, Sectional View. So, in this Sectional View, we are going to see the topic in next full section and half section, partial section, offset section, revolved section, removed section, auxiliary section, and we are going to see the guidelines for hatching, examples on all about types of section of machine elements. Okay, so first of all we are going to see what is mean by sectional view. A sectional view is obtained by imagining the object as if cut by a cutting plane and the portion between the observer and the section plane being removed. Figure shows an object with the cutting plane passing through it and figure the two halves drawn apart exposing the interior details. See here, in the sectioning we are going to tell you what is mean by sections and how we are going to taking a section and why required to take a section. To produce a sectional view, a cutting plane is imagined cutting through the parts as shown in figure. Here we have taken one cutting plane. This is our object and we want to imagine how the holes are looks from inside, because when you looks this object from outside, we cannot able to imagine that how looks from inside, because sometimes when the person who want to manufacture the product, he required to understand thoroughly about how the object can be looks. So that's why we are using sectional view or sectioning in our orthographic views. So whatever orthographic views we are taking, like front view, top view, side view, in this view sometimes the object cannot be understand from inside. The front view or top view can explain outside about the object, but how our object looks from inside, that we cannot be able to understand. So because of this, what we are going to do, we are going to cut our object, and whenever we are taken a cut, how it looks from inside, that we can understand. So this is called as sectioning. So this is, we are taking one imaginary plane, then we are going to cut our object. When you cut your object, then you will realize that what is the cavity given inside, how it looks, because every cavity having its own dimension, having some nature. So when you taken a cut, that time you will realize that how it looks from inside. Okay, so that's why we have taken here cut. Now I will going to explain this with one example. This is one object and this is a cutting plane cut at mid level. When you taken a cutting imaginary plane here, this object will separate at two separate entities. This is one separate entity and then this is second separate entity. So here we have done the hatching. We have done the hatching where there is a part is a solid one. So this part is a solid one, this part is solid one, this part is solid one. So whatever this remaining thing, this is a hollow. Okay, and whatever the cutting plane we have taken cut, that is not going to touch this hollow part. Okay, so where actually the plane and the object get contact at that solid part, we are going to do hatching. And we are showing a section, okay, like half full section means we have taken here, actually here we have taken one cutting plane with slit, so that because of these parts are separate out and one part we are drawing as a view, sectional view. So here we have done sectioning. So whatever this looks from inside, that actually we are drawing here. Okay, so that any one person can understand that how the holes looks from inside. So this is the important thing. Now second things we are observing here is a cutting plane line. So what is this cutting plane line? So below figure shows two lines patterns used to show the cutting plane line. Here is the arrowheads. This arrowheads indicate the direction in which the cut object is viewed, because whenever you are taken a or we are showing cutting plane, it means that in drawing we are showing this cutting plane. This is A, we can give name, and we are showing here arrowheads. When you are showing arrowhead, it means that in this direction we are going to view whatever the cut object, and whatever we are observing there, we are going to draw a sectional view on a paper. Here we have shown here some dimension. These are some standard dimension. Whatever the gap in between these two lines, this is 1.5 mm approximately, and the big line is equal to 6 mm approximately, and the small line is equal to approximately 3 mm. Now again we are going to understand this concept by taking cutting plane. This is our one object. We have taken this cutting plane here. We'll cut our object here. When you will cut this object by imaginary plane, remove this plane side, you will get your object by like this. Okay, this is a half portion of this object. This is a half portion of this object. See here. So whatever this object we have taken cut, so this is the cutting plane arrows. Actually, whatever we have taken a cut, so this is the arrow points towards section viewing, section being viewed. So this observer, or we are observing this object from this side, and this is one more example. Whatever we have taken this object at this cutting plane, we have taken a cut. When you take a cut of this object, whatever the object remaining will remove aside, and whatever this remain, we will done hatching. Okay, so whatever this is solid part, we have done hatching. So here this remaining object we have drawn. Okay, so this is your sectional view, and this is hole, and this is this hole. Okay, kept as it is a blank. Then rules for lines: show edges and contours which are now visible behind the cutting plane. Omit hidden lines in section view. A section lined area is always completely bounded by visible outline. The section lines in all hatched areas for that object must be parallel. Visible lines never cross section line areas. Okay, so these are some rules for drawing a sectional view. So see here one more example of full section. This is our problem. We have taken here a sectional view. Okay, so this is a side view, and this is front view of our object. And in object or in a question, cutting plane is shown like this. So whenever we are drawing a sectional view, first of all see the direction of your cutting plane. So this is the direction of our cutting plane. So here I will remove this portion by side. This portion we are going to remove for side. So whatever it looks like, then we are going to draw here. So see here, whenever you remove this half portion, we are going to see from this side, and you will look like this. Okay, so this is our sectional view. So here we have done here hatching. This part also we have done hatching. This also we have done hatching. Whatever solid parts. Okay, so always remember this thing, very much important. Where is the solid part? That part we are doing a hatching marks. And those are empty, we always keep it is as it is. Okay, so where we are not doing this. So here is the shape of the hole. Okay, so remaining thing we are going to do a hatching. Now we are observing here one more example. See, this is our object, and first of all we are going to see which one is cutting plane direction. So this is our cutting plane. So this is a full sectional view, actually example of full sectional view. So it is a bearing. This is the direction shown in your figure, and this is the A, and this is the direction for view, cutting plane. So when we remove this half portion below, you will look like our object like this. Okay, this is looks like our object. And here whatever the solid parts we have done hatching mark here. So this is hatching mark, this is hatching mark, this is hatching, this is hatching. And whatever the hole, here is a hole. So this part is remain as it is. This is hole, this is hole, this is hole, this is hole. Okay, and then this drawing we are drawing as a sectional view. So see here, actually here is a gap, but we have drawn here full line. Here also gap, but we have drawn here the full line. So it is a rule for drawing a sectional view. When there is a gap, we can take as the back side of this and we'll draw a full line here. Okay, and we never show the hidden line in a sectional view. Okay, unless and until it is very important. Okay, if there is very much important things required to show, then and then only we can use. Otherwise we are not showing hidden lines in a sectional view. Okay, now we are going to see the correct and incorrect methods of sectioning of machine limbs. So all these are the incorrect methods and this is the correct method. Now we are going to see why this is the incorrect method and why this is the correct method. Okay, so see, first of all, this is a problem and this is a cutting plane. This is a direction for a cutting plane. Now we are going to remove this one. We'll observe on whatever the cut part of the sectional view and we'll draw here. So this is a hole, this is hole, will remain kept as it is. This is hole, this is a hole, this is a hole, again this is hole, and whatever remaining part we have done the hatch. Okay, so this is a correct method. Remaining four methods are wrong methods. Why remaining four methods are wrong? So see here, in this first method, what they have done wrong thing? Hatching pattern. See here, the hatching pattern here and here are different. Okay, the angle of this and this is different. So always the angle must be in a one line, in a one direction. Okay, so this is right. That's why this first one is a wrong one. Second one, here the inside hole is shown is a hidden line, dotted line is shown here. So as per rule, we never shows hidden lines in a sectional view. So we have shown here complete line. That's why again second one is a wrong one. So now discuss with our third one, our internal hole. Again here, whatever the holes present, that is shown here hidden line. One more thing, so actually does not require to show here such kind of thing. So whatever this hole is, they have shown here dotted. So this is a wrong one. Again the fourth one is also wrong one. Because why this is a wrong one? Show see here, we cannot we require to draw a full lines outside. Okay, we have drawn all where full lines, but here the lines are not complete. So okay, it is a kept blank. Here also blank, here also blank, here also blank, here also blank. So that's why again this one is a wrong one. So these 1, 2, 3, 4 methods are wrong, and only this is the correct method. So you require to follow this method while you are drawing your sectional view. Okay. Now, one more thing is here, cross hatching. Now we are going to discuss about whenever you are doing a hatching or we are doing a lines for sectioning, hatching lines, which things required to keep in mind. So here, cross hatching patterns shown in figure are used to present general material type. Make hatching lines at 45 degrees with horizontal unless they look better at different angle. Okay, so this angle must be a 45 degree or sometimes maybe 30 or 60 degree or some other angle, but the lines must not be never parallel with your object line. This is object line and these lines are shown here parallel with these lines, so this is a wrong one. Okay, and here the lines are shown perpendicular with your outside line. Again, it is a wrong one. The angle must be a 45 degree. Commonly we are using a 45 degree angle for showing your hatching pattern, and 30 degree and 60 degree mostly other time we can use, but never use like this parallel and perpendicular. Now I will tell you one more thing important in this ribs in section view. Okay, sometimes there are ribs present in our object, so what to do? So again, some webs, gear teeth and other similar flat features are maybe present in your object. So most of the thing keep in your mind, when there is a rib in your object and if our cutting plane is passed through our rib, we never do a sectioning or hatching to that rib. We are going to keep rib as it is, okay, blank. We never do hatching to your rib. So whatever the remaining thing, solid part, we will do the hatch. So this is our object. We have taken here this cutting plane. Okay, here we have taken a cutting plane. This one is a, and when it pass through this one. Okay, so we are going to remove this object from this side, and then this is our rib. So here we never do hatching to rib pattern. So whatever you will see here, whatever shown here, hatching in a rib patterns, this is a wrong method. Okay, so this is a correct method. So like this, whenever there is a rib into your object, never do hatching. Okay, so like this is a incorrect method and this is a correct method. Okay, now we are going to see one more example here. I will show you one more example of full sectional view here. This is a object, this is a direction of view, and we have taken this cutting plane here. This is object top view, and we have drawn here a cutting plane here. This is our cutting plane, and this is a direction of view. When you taken a cutting at this cutting plane at this object, will remove whatever the remaining part from this object, and you are able to see like this. This hole will kept as it is blank. This hole again we are kept as it is blank. Then for this inside hole, okay, so whatever there is a where the job is cut by plane and which one is a solid part, we will do hatching here. Here also hatching, here also hatching, here also hatching, and here also hatching. Whatever remaining part where the object has not touched the cutting plane, that will remain as it is. So like this, we are showing a full sectional view. I think you have understand in today's lecture what is mean by sectioning, why we are doing a sectioning, what is mean by cutting plane, and how to show a full sectional view, what is the wrong methods to show a sectional view, what is the right method to show sectional view, and when there is a rib, how to do a sectioning. So thank you very much. In today's lecture we have learned this thing, and whatever remaining things of the drawing about sectioning we will see in the next lecture. Thank you very much.